Good afternoon, YouTube. So one of the things I've wanted to do on my 3D printer is set it up for printing nylon. So for nylon, one of the better surfaces to use is called Garolite. So this is some Garolite-LE from McMaster Carr. It's a 16th inch thick. It's kind of a fiber reinforced phenolic, and it's quite smooth. And supposedly nylon prints very well on this. It adheres properly and releases, and I think you can print without a heated bed, or I think you can heat it too. I'll have to find out what the best printing parameters are. What I've been using up till now is on my BuildTak build surface, I put glue stick over. And so what I'll do is maybe pick a side of the build surface and then keep all my parts on that glue stick surface. So that does work, but it's a little tedious. You've got to put the glue stick on, and now with my BuildTak flex plate, I can rotate this around so that glue stick surface is moving around all the time, and I have to remember where it is so that I print my other parts, like in ABS, on the part of the build plate that's not got glue stick. Or you have to remove the glue stick, which means you got to take the build plate out and rub it down with alcohol and scrape off the glue stick residue. So that's why I wanted to do the Garolite, because that would be a dedicated nylon print surface. So the question was always how to attach this Garolite to my print bed. Because that print bed it's a monolithic bed. It's got the aluminum base plate, and then the heated bed, and then a glass surface. And when I went to the BuildTak flex plate kit, you glue down a magnetic base, and then there's a steel plate that sticks down to the magnetic base, and then you would normally put your BuildTak on top of the steel plate. But my idea was to get some Garolite, so this is a 12 by 12 sheet, and then BuildTak. You can buy additional steel plates here. Let's take a look at this. So I picked up this extra plate here. There we go. So they sell these separately. This 12 inch square flex plate blank is $35. And then I've got that plate, and that looks like it's going to fit. So that'll go there. And then to stick the two together, what I figured I would try, this is some double-sided Kapton tape. Oh yeah, yeah, it's got adhesive on both sides, so it's adhesive there, and then it's got the peel-up protective layer on top. So my thinking is I'm going to lay down strips of Kapton tape across here, and you can get wider double-sided Kapton tape. I figured I would get the narrow stuff because it seems like it all comes in 36 yard rolls. I went with the narrower tape because one is I don't want to overlap at all, so I figure with the narrow tape I can run right along the edge and then maybe space out every 3/4 inch just so I don't have to be perfectly lined up, leave small gaps between the rows of tape. And I went with the narrower stuff because this would also be useful for re-adhering like things like LED strip light, because those have the 3M adhesive on the back, and sometimes that adhesive wears out and it no longer sticks. Well, this would be perfect for that. It's a high temperature sticky adhesive, so I figure I'm not going to use 100 feet of tape here. And so that was half inch Bertech Kapton tape, double-sided. Yeah, I guess I gotta get everything cleaned up, and I'll show you what it looks like once I get the tape applied here, since that'll probably take a little bit. Then we can go try it out. I'm just getting ready to do some nylon parts in my 3D printer, so I think that would be a good time to test that out. So I'll show you what that looks like when we get to that point.